हाय, अभिषेक फ्रॉम अभी एंड्रॉयड, एंड हेयर आई वांट टू टॉक अबाउट लीनियर लेआउट। सो व्हाट इज लीनियर लेआउट? लीनियर लेआउट अरेंजेस द व्यू ग्रुप ऑल व्यूज इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन, एंड व्हेन वी से इन स्ट्रेट लाइन, नाउ वी हैव टू ओरिएंटेशन पॉसिबल। इट कैन आइदर अरेंज द व्यूज फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट, और इट कैन अरेंज फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम। व्हेन इट अरेंजेस फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट, इट इज कॉल्ड एज हॉरिजॉन्टल ओरिएंटेशन, and when it arranges from top to bottom, it is called as vertical orientation. Now, just for an example, consider that we have two buttons in our app. First one is add to cart, and the second one is a buy now button. So we have two buttons, and we want them to be arranged from left to right. Right in the bottom of the screen, we want that the first half will be add to cart, and the second half will be buy now button. So in that case, you can use this called as horizontal orientation to arrange the buttons from left to right. And for vertical orientation, you can consider example of an address form. We have an address in which the customer will fill his detail, like in the first edit text, he can enter detail like his location, then his street, his zip code. We have different edit texts, and when you will arrange those views, You can use vertical orientation to arrange them from top to bottom. So that's how you will use this orientation. Now I will get inside my Android Studio and I will explain you linear layout in detail. Okay, I will create a new project. I will choose empty activity, click on next. I will call this project as linear layout. I will accept the defaults, click on finish. Now Android Studio will set up the project for us. All right, the project is now set up, and in front of us we have this main activity.java class, and we have this activity underscore main.xml file. So basically this Java class is where you will do your coding for functionality, like if somebody taps on the button, what will happen. So for that you will write a code over here. And inside your XML file, you will design your layouts. So like you want to design some login form, sign up form, you will design inside your XML file. You can also open this file from resource folder, then go to your layout folder, and here you will find your XML file. In fact, this layout folder is kind of layout manager where you will find your all layout files. If you want to create new layout files, you will create it inside this particular folder. Now let me just get rid of some of the stuff so you can see my screen more clearly. Coming back to the designing our layout, Android Studio gives you three ways. First way is the code option. In the code option, you just have to code to design your layout. After that, you can run the app either in emulator or in your real device. You can see the changes after the app is running in your phone. The second option you have is the split mode. In the split mode, you can code over here, and you can see the changes right on the screen. Means if I change this text from hello world to ABCD, you can see instantly it has made the changes on the screen too. So this is a great way to have this environment where you just change in the code, and as soon as you make changes, instantly they appear on the screen. So you know what you are designing. The third option you have here is design mode. In the design mode, you can simply drag and drop on the screen. So this is the third option, and here you will find your all the available attributes. So this is the third options you have. I personally use the split mode or the design mode. Now for this video, I will use this particular split mode. Now first thing first, let me get rid of some of the stuff. Also, you can see by default Android Studio gives us constant layout. I will change this constant layout to linear layout. I will remove this particular tag and I will type linear. And you can see Android Studio is now showing me the options. From the option, I will choose linear layout and press enter. Here, notice that not only the starting tag is changed, also the closing tag of linear layout is changed. So that's how Android Studio is making your coding easier. Means it will show you the option, you just have to choose, and it will make the changes. The studio knows where in other places where it needs to make the changes. So definitely you have to use this feature if you want to improve your performance. coming back to the topic, let me get rid of some more of this stuff. Basically first let's talk about this particular line. So this particular line is called as URI, Uniform Resource Identifier. If I remove this line of code, you can see I am getting errors. This linear layout won't work, this Android resource won't work, means we have defined the attributes, they won't work. And that's actually because they are fetched from this particular line of code. So if you remove this URI, this linear layout tag and other Android resource won't work. So you have to define this particular line of code. Now for this part, we don't need this two namespace. I will simply remove them. Now we are getting error since we have removed it. I will also remove this part. We don't need that too. And we don't need this constant layout attribute too, since we have changed the constant layout to linear layout. So now what we have is a very, very basic setup of linear layout. There's a linear layout, and inside that linear layout, there's a text view. And in the text, what is written? A, B, C, D. In fact, I will change this text view to button, so you can see it more clearly on the screen. I will zoom it more. So now you can see it more clearly on the screen. Let me just change the text of the button from ABCD to home. I will copy this particular button and create three more buttons. So now we have three buttons. First is home. In fact, all are currently have a text home. I will change the text for second button to call. For third button, I will change to buy now. So we have three buttons now. First one is home, second button is call, third is buy now. Now here you can see that all the three buttons are aligned from left to right, means they are aligned horizontally. That means this linear layout, if we don't define the orientation, by default the orientation is horizontal. If I define the orientation over here and change this to vertical, you can see they are now aligned from top to bottom. So that's how linear layout orientation works. If I change this orientation to horizontal, they will go back and align themselves from left to right. So that's how orientation works. And also notice that currently we have set attributes for this linear layout is match parent. When I click on this linear layout, you can see this blue color rectangle, which is telling us that this particular linear layout is using the whole width and height of the screen. If I change the height to wrap content, just see on the screen. Now this particular linear layout is only using the height which is required, means it currently needs only this much of the height, so it is only using this much of the heights. So that's how wrap content works. Means in wrap content, the layout will take the least amount of space possible. It needs to just fit on the screen. For now, I will change this to match parent, and you can see instantly on the screen, now it is using the whole screen. For the button, you can see this particular button is using this much width and this much height. If by chance, let's say we want to use this particular button to use whole available width. So for that, we will change this to match parent. And you can see now this particular button is using the whole width available on the screen, and the other two buttons have become invisible. They are available, but they won't show on the screen because this particular button is using the whole width available from the linear layout. So we will change this back to wrap content so we can see our other two buttons. Also notice, since they are aligned from left to right, the second button is aligned from left to right, and it is as close as it can to the first button. So that's how alignment works when you will set orientation to horizontal. Now, next part I want to talk about is how to add attributes inside a button. For example, you can see that the first button is very close to the top left of the screen. What we want to add some space or some gap between the first button and the top left of the screen. So how we can do that? It's very simple. We just have to use the margin attribute. We will use margin left and let's say we put 20 dp. So you can see that this particular button has created a gap towards its left side of 20 dp. So that's how margin left works. We can also use margin right, and we have other options for margin top, margin bottom. So that also we can use. And this is how you will define margin, how you will use attributes for particular for your views. If I copy and paste this particular margin line of code and paste it inside other button also, you will see now the gap is created. The second button is also has a gap from the first button, and the third button also has a gap from the second button. So this is how this particular margin attributes work. And if we define margin itself for the parent linear layout, you will see, let me just define it, you will see that this particular linear layout has moved 20 dp from the left side also, 20 dp from the top, from the right, and from the bottom. So this is how margin works if you will define for the parent layout itself, means for the linear layout itself. I will just remove it so we can see it more clearly on the screen. Now how to find out all the available attributes for this particular button. For that, you just go to the design mode, and in the design mode simply click on the views, like I click on the button or buy now button, and here in this part you can see common attributes, and if I scroll down, I will also see all attributes. So from here, from this list, you can find all the available attributes for this buy now button. You can change it to call or home button. Since they are buttons, so the attributes will be same for every other view. Now let's, for example, if I click on this home button and change the background tint, which is currently purple, if I change this to orange, you can see the first button background has changed to home. Similarly, we can change for call also. Let's say we make it blue, and for buy now we can make it to green. So that's how you can use this attribute part. And in fact, you can just spend some time and experiment with attributes, and you can see the changes. As soon as you make changes over it, you can see it, the changes on the screen too. And when you make changes in the design mode, you will notice that the changes will reflect inside the code also. Means when you make changes over here, instantly those changes will be reflected in the code also. So that's how this split and design mode works. Now we have discussed about orientation, we have discussed about how to add new attributes, and I will end this video over here. And in the next video, I will talk about gravity, and then I will also show you how to add a linear layout within other linear layout. I will also talk about weight. Just to give you a brief overview, gravity is basically tell where to position the view inside this particular linear layout. And through weight, we will tell how much space that this particular view will get inside this particular linear layout. So those are the two different attributes. And I will see you in the next video and discuss it with you.